I am totally convinced now, more than ever, that cable television, filthy movies, both in the theater and the home VCRs, is going to be the number one cause of hearts being prepared for the Antichrist. The number one. Because the eye is the gate to the heart. And he's going to march right through the eye and take control and sit on the throne of the heart because of filthy, corrupted, jaded eyes. We know the Antichrist is in full control of the secular media. All secular television, theater, all the networks, all the printed material, all now are under the control of the spirit of Antichrist. Who but Antichrist could so bias the American press and so bias the editors and the writers and the actors so that abortion is called a right rather than a sin? Who but the Antichrist could justify now euthanasia? Did you hear recently, or read in the newspaper, a psychiatrist now in the United States who believes in euthanasia, killing off the old and infirm? He's willing to kill off anybody who's mentally ill. Who but Antichrist is a killer? Kill off the old and the infirm. We ought to be shocked in the United States because in the Philippines and in Asia, they honor and they revere their old folks. Those who are old, they're revered. Here, we want to kill them. Who but the spirit of Antichrist could be behind it? Who but Antichrist could mock everything that's sacred and holy and worshipped and filthy movies and wicked, vile programs on television? The Antichrist is producing MTV. Literally, the Antichrist spirit is in full control of Fox television. Just look at some of the reviews and some of the absolute filth. Who but the Antichrist? Who but the spirit of Antichrist could be behind it? And folks, he's getting bolder and bolder. Our society is on the brink of becoming a raging hell. But sadly, that same Antichrist spirit is moving rapidly into the Church of Jesus Christ. We talk about the gates of hell not prevailing against the church. But folks, you've got to know that he's talking about a certain church, an overcoming holy remnant church. He's not talking about that great church mess that's out there being ruled and reigned by the spirit of Antichrist. He's talking about a particular church called out from the world. Only that church will prevail. The gates of hell will not touch that church. But I'm telling you right now, all over the United States, the spirit of Antichrist is absolutely establishing churches. You go ahead and you go to the show, go to a movie, pluck down your $5 or $6, and you sit there and listen to me good enough. You sit there. Well, there's blood and violence. And you sit there. Well, the name of Jesus Christ is cursed and mocked and run through the mud and trampled. And the name of your holy God is cursed. And I'm going to tell you what you've done. You've just drunk from the cup of the devil. You have fellowship with demons. And you've provoked God to jealousy. And you have supported the Antichrist spirit. And the Antichrist spirit that Satan sees where you're at. He knows where you're sitting in the seat of the ungodly. And you're going to sit there. And you're going to take that. Even PG-13 now. Even PG's cursed the name of Jesus. Do you not even have the grace to get up and walk out? You sit there. You wouldn't sit there and let them curse your wife or your husband. You wouldn't sit there and let them curse your... They named your children like that. You would get up and scream and say, stop it, and run out. And yet you'll sit there and let the name of your Christ be maimed. Sit in front of television and watch filthy, filthy, rotten stuff. And let that spirit of Antichrist seep into your soul. Provoking the Lord to jealousy. You know what it is? It's called a sacrifice to the devil. That's what God calls it, a sacrifice to demons. God help us. And what agreement hath the temple of God with idols? For ye are the temple of the living God. As God hath said, I will dwell in them and walk in them, and I will be their people, and they shall be my people. Look at me, please. How can such an incredible, awful, frightful thing happen that at one time the living God sat on his throne ruling and reigning in a vessel? How is it Now that the Holy Ghost has departed and that temple, that throne of the heart has been vacated. Through lust, through pride, through covetousness, through gossip, through slander, through all of the things that we've been warned about time after time after time. How is it that we have many Christians who have grown careless, who don't walk righteously before Him anymore? And how is it that the spirit of Antichrist has moved in now and taken over, and according to this 2 Thessalonians, the second chapter, he now sits in his temple, showing himself to be God. In other words, he is in control. He is absolutely in control. There is always going to be a Christ on your throne. I don't care where you are, serving Jesus or serving the old, there will always be a Christ on this throne. It will either be Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, or the Antichrist. There will be a Christ. Every man walking these streets has a Christ on his throne. Now folks, listen to me. There are going to be Christians overcome by the spirit of Antichrist that's at work right now. They're going to be overcome. These are those who've escaped the pollutions of the world, who were delivered by the power of God through the knowledge of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. But now they've turned aside, for it had been better for them not to have known the way of righteousness. They knew the way. They knew the way of righteousness. Then, after they have known it, to turn from the holy commandment delivered unto them. But it's happened unto them according to the true proverb, the dog has turned to his own vomit again, the sow that was washed to her own wallowing in the mire. How many, look at me please, how many do you know who have turned away from God and they're going back to their old habits? They've gone back to their old world. Folks, I'm going to tell you, you don't just backslide. You don't just fall away from the Lord. What does a sinner have to fall away from? He can't fall away from anything. He's already in the pit. The only falling away are those who have something. You don't just fall away from Jesus. You fall into something. It's not just the falling away, it's falling into. You fall away from Christ and you fall into the spirit of Antichrist. Let no man deceive you by any means. For that day shall not come except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition, who opposeth and exalted himself above all that is called God, or that is worshipped, so that he as God sitteth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. For the mystery of iniquity doth already work. Only he who now letteth will let, until he be taken out of the way. Then shall that wicked, or the Antichrist, be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming, even him whose coming is after the working of Satan with all power and signs and lying wonders, with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they receive not the love of the truth, that they might be saved. And for this cause God shall send them strong delusion, that they should believe a lie, that they might be damned who believe not the truth, but had pleasure in unrighteousness. It's not New Age, it's Antichrist. It's Antichrist. And his spirit now is moving and taking control over all the secular. He's taking control of government, and now that spirit is moving into the church. Now listen to this. Little children, it is the last time. How many believe that? How many believe this is the last time? Folks, if it was the last time when John wrote this, can you imagine how late it is now? Almost 2,000 years later, how much closer, how more real is this text? Little children, it's the last time. You've heard that Antichrist shall come. Even now there are, what? Many Antichrists, whereby we know that it is last time. It means that there are many that have been infiltrated and possessed by the spirit of Antichrist. The spirit of Antichrist, John is saying, is already moving. It's in many hearts. Now, in this passage, John is telling us those whose hearts are still in love with the world, those who are still bound by lust, have opened themselves to the spirit of Antichrist. The lust of the flesh, the lust of the eye, the pride of life, it's not of the Father. Who's it of? It's of the Antichrist. And there are many that are still given over to that. Who is a liar? But he that denieth that Jesus is the Christ. He is what? Antichrist, that denieth the Father and the Son. Anyone, John is saying, who has not come under the total lordship of Jesus Christ, has opened himself to the spirit of Antichrist. If you sit here this morning and he is not Lord of everything in your life, you've given him a portion of your life, you're serving him 90%, But he is not totally Lord in your life. You have denied him. You've denied his lordship. It's not that you go around cursing his name, but you have denied him. You have not believed to him for full salvation. You have believed and trusted him for half salvation. You are not serving him with all your heart and mind and soul and body. You have opened yourself, according to John, to the inroads, the inmaking of the Antichrist spirit into your heart. This is so very, very clear. Whosoever denieth the Son, the same hath not the Father. But he that acknowledges the Son hath the Son, Father also. It's not just to say, well, I believe Jesus was God in flesh. It's saying, Jesus, you are God in flesh in me, with all power and all authority over lust, over sin and everything else, and I yield to your lordship. Those who are righteous, who worship God in spirit and truth, are the prime targets of the Antichrist spirit, who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God or that is worshipped. This spirit of Antichrist is opposed to those who walk closely with the Lord Jesus Christ, those who walk with God in intimacy, and those who are worshipers. This is what the devil is after. This is what the Antichrist wants for himself. And he's going to come against everybody. He's going to come against every true believer who walks in the intimacy of Jesus Christ. He's going to come against you with everything the Antichrist possesses. That spirit, that invading spirit, he's going to come against you and try to attack you and try to get you to stop worshiping. He'll try to stop your intimacy with the Father. He'll try to give you doubt and fear about the advocacy of the cross of Jesus Christ. He will do everything to make inroads to hinder your worship. There's nothing the devil wants in this church more than the worship. To kill and destroy worship. That's what he wants in you more than anything else. He will do anything. He's not out to get you to be a drug addict, an alcoholic, prostitute. He's not trying to get you to lie and steal and curse. He'll do that only if it disturbs your worship. He'll do it only to rob God of his praises. He's after worshipers. And if you're a worshiper, true worshiper, don't be surprised when everything out of hell comes against you. When the Antichrist spirit comes and tries to knock you away. Don't be surprised by it. Who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God and all that is worship. Paul warns that a spirit of lawlessness is at work in the world and in the church. Now we know what withholdeth that he might be revealed in his time. What and who is withholding the Antichrist from taking over the whole nation and the whole world right now? The Holy Ghost. The Holy Spirit who abides in you, not the Holy Spirit that in some cosmic atmosphere, but the Holy Ghost in the church, the Holy Ghost in you and I. And it's this church and other Holy Ghost church and Holy Ghost people that are holding back the anarchy of hell and Satan in the city. They talk about the crime rate going down or up. Folks, if the Holy Ghost was lifted from this church and other churches, this city would be a raging hell right now. Because the stench of hell is already in our schools, the stench of hell is in our courts, the stench of hell is in our churches. And can you imagine what it would be if the Holy Ghost begins to step aside and say, be revealed. So Holy Ghost holding back the storm. Folks, I'm going to tell you something. Careless, lazy Christians are going to be overcome. They're not going to be able to stand. You're careless about reading your Bible. You're careless about the things of God today. Folks, the perilous times that are coming, and the closer, you see, Jesus says, closer we get to his coming, there's going to be ever-increasing light. And folks, there's ever-increasing revelation, ever-increasing power of the Antichrist is being released by the devil right now before the full revelation of the Antichrist. Because when he comes, he's coming, it's just going to be the last step, like stepping through a piece of tissue paper. It will have all been prepared. The hearts are ready, all prepared for his revelation. He's not going to have to prepare anything. The devil will have already prepared it. The spirit of Antichrist will have already accomplished his will. And sadly, many Christians are going to be overcome.